What's going on, everybody? Coach Lucas here. Let's get this next workout started. Similar format, how we've been doing them. We got our warm up, moving around, getting a little sweat going, nice and loose before we start that shadow boxing. We've got 8 3-minute rounds, working on something different each round. Before the round starts, I'm gonna flash a clip of a pro in a live fight, implement that technique so you see it, and then you hear the bell. We're all working it together. After we finish those rounds, strength and conditioning, we always finish up with. Alright, for all the jawbreakers out there, I know y'all ready to get back in the gym. I am too. Get back to our classes, get back on the meds, get sparring started again, get all of our fighters ready to get back in the fights. I'm getting anxious being home, but it's all good. This is what we got for now, these home workouts, so let's get it started. Alright, we're gonna get this warm up going. This first, I'm gonna tell you what we're doing before the beginning of each round. So, this first round, let's just stand with your feet shoulder width apart. We're just gonna walk it out. Going all the way down, all the way back, and a little bit of a little jump at the top. We're just getting stretched out a little bit here. Moving out, back up. If you're already warmed up, say you've already been put on a run or something, you wanna get a little bit harder with this warm up, add a push up on it. That's good with me. Come all the way out, add that push up, come back, little jump at the top. We're doing this 3 minutes straight, all right? I'm not gonna have to push up. I got a bad shoulder, I'm warming that up. So,
do what you want.
So let's work. First, and breathe all throughout this. Big opponent. Really taking deep breaths, focusing on your breathing, and whatever warm up you're doing, whatever kind of workout, just kind of gets you locked in with your focus, and it's definitely very good for your respiratory system. Minute left. Keep going. Lay something down, we just need a line to work with. So I'm gonna use a jump rope. Straighten it out. A little plyometric drill. A little jump in here. low impact, just staying moving. Second round is warm up. We're gonna start 30 seconds, forward and back, just like this. We'll change it throughout the round, stay moving. Let's go, forward and back. Don't jump high, think about that, you're just moving. Stay on your toes, all right? And also, don't go really far back. You're right here, just clearing that line. Same thing, focus on that breathing. And next 30 seconds, face forward, both feet side to side. Just clearing that line. Next 30 seconds is the last one. Switch steps. Put one foot on each side and land at the same time. Like an Ali shuffle, right? Same thing. Once again, staying on your toes. Don't keep landing heavy on your heels. Avoid that. On your toes. And one more time each. Both feet together now. Forward and back. You're already in position. Pulling them calves up real good today. Side to side. Yeah, I needed this. I've been running a lot more just to get out of the house. I made a gym to tell you, I hate running personally. Only time I do it is in preparation for a fight. Just because it's unavoidable. You gotta get your miles in. So I've been doing more though. Getting my miles up, good fast pace. My feet are pretty sore. I'm not quite used to it yet. This is a good warm up for me. And last 30, switch steps. Hit it better. Keep moving, keep moving. And time. Move your rope. This next round, use the area you got. Maybe you got a bigger space than me, maybe a smaller. Work with what you got, but you're gonna get on the perimeter. What we're gonna do is get in a good stance, aiming at the center. Wherever your circle is, right here, shuffling around. Once you go all the way around and reach the point that you got to, right? So I'm all the way around. Switch. Bend your knees and switch. All right, no matter which direction you start, keep a good stance. Stay on your toes and don't cross your feet. Avoid crossing your feet. Right here. You might find one direction is easier than the other. That's good, notice that. Maybe work on it more on your own. An idea while we're aiming that front foot towards the center, because if they're right there, you gotta aim at them so you could punch right there. If you're shuffling like this, you're out of your stance. If you're aiming in a different direction, you get less balance and you got not much power on it. You're sitting here and you're aiming, boom, boom, boom. You're right there at it. Now, with that said, we're gonna add some stuff here. Start adding with our hand movement. And your jab. Just your jab. hard, still warming up. Just get it out there. Now I want y'all to start fainting a little bit with that jab. Good stutter step thing. Boom, boom, punch right off of it. Now, work in your two, just your straight punches. So you got your feints, you got your jabs, you got your cross.
Difficulties and work time.
On the ground, good deep breath before we start. Stance and work. Good speed drill. Get them hands all the way back to your face. Right. Left.
Left, right,
Right. Right. And your shoulders are getting warm. Mine definitely are. Right. Left. Time was a little off. Do that again. Left. There we go. Right. 15 seconds, y'all. Right. Left. And time. We nice and warmed up now. This next round, we are gonna work on shuffling in and out. The way that you shift your weight is crucial here. So moving forward and back, right? The whole round, we're like this. You can even start with just the footwork. Shuffle, right there. You're not push stepping, you're flowing with it. All right, we're gonna start with just the jab. Notice how I shift my whole body, driving off that back leg, going through my target with that jab. That's where we start. Right hands up, defensive hands up as you're throwing that jab. We get a little bit of head movement as you slide out. Notice how I'm slipping to the right. A little rhythm at the back. Back in. And take that jab to the body now. Notice how I break the plane right here, getting my head off the line. I'm not, boom, off the line. Chin behind that shoulder, sliding right back out. Whip that jab. I want you to push it. Don't, right, lean off balance, too top heavy. Whip it, boom, keeping your weight back, but yet still driving off that back foot. And now, back up top, let's add the cross. Get to the side and get a better view. Break right here, catching your breath, it's in that rhythm right here. And back in. Now let's add a feint. Go back to just a jab, add a stutter step feint right here. Boom, boom, sliding out. So we're still shuffling, throwing the time off a little bit. With that stutter step feint, set it up. Let's take that feint up top like we've been doing. Boom. Shoot that jab to the body. Raise your guard. Open up that solar plex. And let's go. Keep it up top now. Feint. One, two. Upstairs. Moving that head on the way out. Give me a good little roll right there. Roll. As you step out, slide out. Let's go to the bell. One more. And time. This next round, we're gonna get to a little bit more technique with this step back hook. Alright? Now this is a little bit more advanced for a left hook, so everybody out there that's doing this in left hook in general, just a basic left hook, is still new to you and it's a hard punch to get down. So I don't want you to worry about trying to step back with it. I want you to work on just different setups for a good left hook. But everybody out there that's comfortable with it and wants to work on a different way to put it together, that's this step back hook right here. So we're gonna imagine our opponent coming in with their attack. We're gonna give them that space and we're gonna land as we slide out with the push step. ready to throw a left hook. That's how my hips are here. I'm not here. Can't throw a left hook there. As long as I turn a little bit, got my hands up, I can catch if I need to. I can turn my hook off of it. And it's quick. Boom, boom. All right? Check it out. And I can get back on defense, or I can put my right hand up with it. All right? So landing loaded. You can also add a parry to that. I like to do this a lot. I'll knock down there. They come in with a jab. I'll bring that down. Boom. They're orthodox, and I knock their jab down, and they got their right hand low with the jab. They're open. Boom. For that left hook. All right? So either parry or catch. I just slide back into that step back hook. Notice your opponent, they're timing your jab good. Every time you throw a jab, you're noticing you're just getting out of the way with your defense or even getting hit. They're just so quick on it. Maybe they're parrying you and they're coming right back. Set them up with that step back hook. Throw that jab, almost fading it. Just quick with it, just making them think you're committing that jab, but really you're just probing for that step back hook. So you already know they're coming in. They've been doing it. It's been working. Why wouldn't they keep doing it, right? That's that chest match right there. You see what they're doing good, and you exploit them for that. Another way to put it together, it takes real good timing, real good distance control, but you can throw that hook as you step back and land that hook when the back foot lands. You gotta open that hook up, make sure it's high enough, you're not low with it, leaving your chin open for the right hand. Boom. Right there, that timing's a little bit quicker that way. Another good time to work with that method is if you're inside in a foam booth fight. You're close. Right here, you can create that space with that step back hook. Boom, land in the hand, left hand with the right foot. Boxers out there looking to hit and not get hit. All right, it's a great technique for that. It's called a check hook. And I'm gonna show you two different main ways to do this. All right, now, first one I'm gonna show you is the most common, what most coaches are gonna say the correct way to do this is when you got an aggressive fighter coming in, maybe you got the ropes behind you. Let's say that. You got nowhere to go behind you. You gotta get out to the side. You're gonna throw that hook. Boom, as you step like that, landing, bringing that back foot around in your stance, you're able to get back on with your offense. All right, so one more time like that. Coming in. Right, take that step, landing that hook, driving through. Push through your target as you bring that back foot around. It's the most common way. Another way that I like working that I'm gonna do both in this next round we're doing, is just pivoting. Because the benefit of that, if you can pull it off, when you just pivot and you don't take that step, is that still get a decent whip on that hook, but when you land, because that foot didn't bring you out here, you're close to your opponent. that little space might be all the difference in touching them when you come back down and then getting back on defense and making it harder for you to get back on. Right? The difference is right here. My man got the ropes behind. Just turning. My front foot didn't move. That puts me here instead of here where I was if I took the step. Right? Setup difference. All I want you to focus on is moving with your left foot. Get a new angle and back to work. Next round, we're working on setting up our overhand right. Boom, it's coming around. It's a looping punch. It comes around and down. Make sure you're still getting your knuckles on it. You're not slapping it right through your knuckles. It's naturally by nature gonna be more of a telegraph punch, like a cross on a pipe. Boom, straight from A to B right there. But you gotta mix that in. If you've been giving them those looks every now and then, coming around their guard like that. So, with that said, because it is more telegraphed by nature, you want to set it up. One of the most common ways to jab to the body. Boom, boom. That gets them to drop their guard down, catching your jab, and leaving them exposed. And if they're not sharp enough with the defense, it's a big punch. A lot of knockouts come from this big overhand, right? So let's work on setting it up.
Thank you.
under the body with the jab over top of that leg. Canelo knocked out Amir Khan. That beautiful overhand right. He set it up with a jab to the body. He was working it, then he just feinted it. Khan's looking for that jab to the body to land, but he just flashed it. Boom, let it out halfway out, right to that overhand. I don't know, but beautiful knockout. Coming out with my head on the line. Something I'm picking up, I need to work on. Time. Next round, we're gonna be working a hook to the body, setting up a lead uppercut. So right here, boom, touch it to the body, driving your uppercut off of it. Now, there's two main ways to throw it. Like I just demonstrated there, I brought the hand back to my head, loading up with that second uppercut. It's gonna be a tad bit slower than if you go right to it off of landing that body shot. Here, boom, boom, to go right to it. That natural, bringing my hand back before I shoot it, it's gonna slow it down a little bit, but it's a little bit safer. And that's what you're working on this round, is kind of working both, getting a feel of how you feel for your style with your speed capability, what you might work in a fight if you were to throw this combo. All right, so once again, it's either boom, boom, or it's all right, one's a little bit quicker, but a little bit more risky. This. Next round, we're gonna be doing that same technique, just on the other side. So last round, we did the left hook to the body, to left uppercut. This round, we're doing the right hook to the body, right uppercut. And same thing I said that last round about two different main ways to do it. One is a little bit slower, but a little bit smarter defensively to bring the hand back to the head, loading the hips, bring it from your face for that uppercut, versus a little bit quicker, boom, boom. Going right to it. As soon as you touch that, drive it straight up. Okay? One's a little bit quicker, but it's a little bit higher of a risk doing it that way because your face is exposed. So work both of them, see what works for you. This technique off of slipping one of the straight punches coming in. That's gonna go over my shoulder. I'm gonna see. Boom. So it's a jab from an orthodox fighter right there. Get my back foot up and get back in my stance. Boom. Shoot that uppercut off of it. I'm seeing that jab. Waiting for it. I know what's coming. I can read them. I already read that. As soon as he starts feeling himself, it's obvious. He's dancing around, hands down, showboating to the max, all right? Now, maybe not take it to that extreme, maybe keep it a little bit more technical, but I want you to feel yourself this round. So it's a freestyle round. Keep it as technical as you want, showboat as much as you want. You might have a no-nonsense coach that would get on you in a heartbeat if he saw you doing that, and that's fine. Just treat it as a freestyle round. But I want you to put yourself in that mindset where you are beating the snot out of your opponent, and there's nothing they can do about it, right? You're just killing their confidence. Everything you do, you can't miss, and they can't land. Feel yourself this round. Strength to conditioning now. Setting this off, it's gonna be a little bit more jump training, a little bit harder than the warm-up was, similar, more isolated. So let's start getting aligned again. So if you already got one on the floor, that's great. If not, grab a jump rope, really anything that's something to clear space. Ultimately, you really don't need one, but it just kind of helps you visually, right? I'm gonna hit the timer, we've got 3 minutes. This first round is starting on the left leg. We're gonna be side to side. All right, don't rush it. It's time, so I don't care how many times you're going back and forth. Then second 30 seconds is gonna be switching to the right foot. And again, it's gonna be back to the left, but forward and back. Same thing to the right, forward and back. That makes 2 minutes. The last full minute of this 3 minute round is gonna be both feet facing forward. But as you're going side to side, like we did in the warm up, you're going down and up. Alright, it's gonna be brutal. Let's do it. Time is about to go off. In position. Everybody start on the left leg. Work time. 30 seconds. Right here. Might sound silly, but think light. magic float. You're not heavy. You're heavy. It's gonna be harder on you. Pinch you up. I gotta be floating. Muhammad Ali out there in the ring. Floating like a butterfly. Couple seconds. And switch to the right. Fully relax that left leg. Are you fresh right now? Somewhat fresh. Back to the left foot, forward and back. You got bad knees? Maybe you sit this one out. It's really bad, but that said, I've had 2 knee surgeries myself on this leg, and I'm still going, so. Be honest with yourself. Right foot. There to the hardest part yet. Feet together. Work your way down and up. Ooh, full minute here. Seconds. 10 seconds. Take that rope out of the way, whatever you use. Next one, we got 3 sets. Every 30 seconds, switching it up. A push-up variation. We got push-up, shoulder touch, alternating. We got push-up, sit back, stretch some shoulders out, then last one, slow, down and up. Max Wayne, I'm gonna get a break, I'm talking the whole time, it's all good, let's go. In 30 seconds with that, sit back. Seconds, slow. Take a little tiny break with a deep breath and keep going. Back to the shoulder touches. Let you to the sit back. And slow push up till you hear the bell. The way up ain't no joke. Stay strong. This last one might be easy for some of y'all, might be harder for others. We're gonna hit just a straight up wall sit. Fairly low, don't make it too easy on yourself. 3 minutes here, should burn. Alright, find a wall. Don't tell my wife I'm putting sweat all over a wall. And let's get low. Alright, here, uh-oh. Man. Like feet gonna make it even harder. Of course, we could talk about upcoming fights. Just saying, make sure you're watching this coming up. This guy does that. All you talk about is fighters to go back and watch. But you can just type in boxing on YouTube and see all different kind of styles. Just dig into the crates. It's all there. But it ain't nothing like watching a fight. You don't know the result to that on the edge of your seat. Anything could happen. I miss watching boxing live. Can't wait till this stuff clears up. Back to normal. What's crazy is they might not be able to have big crowds for a long time. So it's just fighters in the arena, or in a ring. It might not even have to be an arena with no fans. But I'm wondering, that's not a big deal. But what I'm wondering is, are they going to get paid the same? I hate for guys to get big cut, and the guys that will get cut the most from their payment is the guys that aren't getting that much already compared to the top dog. So, who knows? I don't know anything about it yet, but I would imagine with all of that money coming in from the big crowd, how are they gonna pay these guys as much? I don't know. We'll see. Strength and conditioning, y'all. Shake it out, shake it out. Let's get these abs. Last thing. Setting off this first round, it's gonna be weighted Russian twist. So go ahead and lay your mat out and also grab something that is gonna count as your weight. Whether you actually got a dumbbell or kettlebell, something you can use. I'm gonna use, what's that? I stole a box of Pampers from my newborn. It's about 12 pounds. might want to get a heavier weight and go, or you might have to go a little bit slower, a few less reps, but I'm gonna be able to really go with this. I plan on being able to keep going the whole 2 minutes, but that's what it's gonna be. This is starting off. We got 3 2-minute rounds for the abs. Let's do it.
Set this timer.
In position, feet are up, that's your plate. I want you to touch that weight to the ground. Work time.
Hope y'all aren't having to stop as much as myself.
All day. All I can do is what I can do.
Almost there. I ain't gonna drop it yet.
No matter how much it burns.
Get your weight out of there. Come on up in a plank position. And go side to side, kind of like a rainbow with our plank. Dip in your hips. Right there. Stretch it out. So like this.
Great combination with those Russian twists.
Halfway.
Oh, too many breaks for me. Hope you aren't having to stop as much as me.
Come on, come on. Almost there.
One more breath.
Do these right here. Now B, your feet down, you're gonna sit up position right, you're gonna lay back, hands either straight or arms straight, hands between your legs, and you're gonna reach up, chin up, feeling that crunch all the way. Exhale, down as you inhale, pick one hand, exhale a little bit farther, down, other hand. So both, one, two, down, both, one, two. Shadowboxing rounds and what I can do. Thanks for joining me. Stay tuned for the next video.